Hello YouTube, Optimus Smythe back for another video review, and wow, a new Transformers animated toy. I finally found Skywarp. Now, I have found Skywarp in stores before, but I just never wanted to get him because that's how it is with me in repaints. I didn't really see the importance quite yet, but I had lots of money the other day when I was at the store. I was at Kmart. I saw him there. I thought, well, I might as well just get him because, I mean, it's better than nothing. Plus, I'm making a series of the animated figures. It might be good to put him in. The only question is, and I'd like you guys to see if you can answer this. In my animated series, which is based on animated, should I make Skywarp the coward clone that he is in the show? Or should I make him more like the G1 version, who has always been around as probably as long as Sunstorm has... as long as Starscream has, and should I just make him one of his, like, repaint clone, like, brothers? Not a coward, but just another, like, Starscream repaint Transformer. Should I make him like he is in animated, or like in G1, even with a different voice and a different personality? Vote on the bottom. Tell me whether you like the idea of the animated Skywarp in my series, or G1 Skywarp. Tell me in the comments, and I'd appreciate it, because I'm kind of having a hard time figuring that out. Yeah, and this review should be pretty short, because I'm not going to show you how to transform him. One, because it's too easy, and two, I've already done a review of animated Starscream. And here comes my cat. Again.
Hi.
So, yeah. So, I do still have Starscream, obviously, and the unfortunate thing about these repaints is I've heard that repaints always get very loose-jointed. It's, and he was loose-jointed. I guess the reason is because when they're first making... a certain mold that's going to become a repaint later on, like Starscream, for instance, they pay attention because it's the first time. But the second time, when they're making repaints... Get out of here, cat. Here comes my cat. She's bugging me again. But the second time when they make repaints, they hurry through it because they think, oh, well, we've already done this. It's no big deal. And they make a mistake. It's either too loose or it's got problems or who knows what. So, yeah. But it's not bad. He's worth getting. Don't get him, though, if you don't like repaints. But if you're a Skywarp fan, you like how he wasn't animated, and you like the Seeker mold, you should get him. Because these jets are just awesome. Now, first of all, let's put the landing gear in, which is very nice landing gear. And like I said, this jet mold is beautiful. It's cartoon accurate. It's very nice. It's cool how the wings are pointing that way. I don't know if there really are jets like that, but it's still cool. Get out of here. My cat likes to rub her head up against sharp things like the corners of boxes. And there's her tail. Get out. Go on. Okay, now I'm going to transform him for you. And I'm not going to show you how, or I'm not going to at least go into detail with it. Like I said, it's a really, really quick transformation. Bring it down. Da-da-da-da-da. And now we're kind of pretty much done. But, undo the feet. I'm putting him in the pose I usually like for them. Yeah, like with Starscream, I don't like separating this thing right here, and I haven't yet. Because they only pop off really easily. And I don't like them being there anyways. They're kind of gaudy. I don't really see the point of them. So I just keep it like that. So here's Skywarp, and he's transformed. I wish they'd have given him a different face. A scared face, because he's a coward clone, you know? But there's nothing you can do about it. If I do want to make him more G1-ish, though, it's probably a good thing he doesn't have a scared face. Yeah. But there's Skywarp. This posability is the same as Starscream's. The only problem with mine is, for some reason, the corner of this shoulder blade is, like, the shoulder pad is won't turn up so good. I had his waist undone. And if you do, it's kind of hard. You have to, like, skip it up or bend it back, kind of. It'll turn up eventually, but not very well, and it's getting rubbed off. The head is a lot more loose than my Starscream's is, but not loose enough to pop off, but it's easier to turn, at least. The fingers are pretty loose, and they pop off sometimes, kind of. This one, like, the thumb is like, clicking on the fingers and making the fingers move on their own, which is really weird. Yeah, and he doesn't really hold together too well either. Of course, that backpack part never really did. And he was when I got him, he was really, really loose in his thigh joints. But I took care of that. I took a little plastic wrap, or a part of a grocery bag, and I put it, I stuck it in the holes, and then when I put it back together, it's a lot rough now. They'll stay out, so I took care of that. The ankles are kind of loose too, but oh well. The major difference really is no molding difference. Same exact thing as Starscream. It's just a repaint. No molding at all. It's just my figure is a bit loose. The paint difference really is we've got a grayish black. The Gold Decepticon logo is here and here. That goldish orange cockpit still. Orange eyes still. Same color face, pretty much. It's like a bluish purple, and then there's purple, and then like a silvery purple here. And also on his guns, it's silvery purple, and part of the fuselage of the jet. So yeah, that's it, really. I don't have the missiles with me again. They're rather useless, plus they're not show accurate. They look like shark heads, which is weird. But same thing, these things can move. They're in the wrong place, so they should be on the bicep. You can put them up like that if you'd like, for some reason. And if you pull them forward, you'll see this happen still. These awesome little, like, it's like a tri-gun comes out, and you can do it with the other arm, obviously. Which I, once again, I'm very glad they did that for the Starscream figure. I thought it was a really cool thing to add. So now he's got two tri-gun type things, which look really neat. Yeah, and like I said, I'm not going to show you the missiles. They're rather useless. If you want to see what they look like, go watch another person's review of this figure or Starscream. Yeah, so that's Skywarp. I'm still waiting for Thundercracker. I'm afraid it's only going to be a Japanese exclusive. Something has happened with the animated line, and it's not Hasbro's fault. It's Cartoon Network's, because they're not releasing Season 3 on DVD. They didn't allow them to make a Season 4 because they were angry about them making Transformers Prime, the new series. So that's slowing down Hasbro with the animated toy line, and it's slowing down Hasbro, though. Takara, I'm sure, is doing great because animated is premiering now in Japan. So everybody's probably going crazy for animated over in Japan. We still need to give them support, though, guys. If you can, if you really would like to, order these things online or buy them at stores. They need our support. Let's hope and pray they can make a Season 4 in at least in comic form. Okay? So, yeah. But the animated toy line is pretty much going all Japanese, or if it isn't, it's going exclusives. Like Rodimus and Ironhide are going to be exclusives at Toys R Us, I think. It's a nightmare. But please still get the figures, because I am a huge fan of the animated line. And for those of you out there who are, support Hasbro. Buy the figures. Buy the comics. Get the Allspark Almanac also. I command all of you, buy it, okay? Buy the Allspark Almanac. I still have yet to find it, okay? So yeah, that's it for my first Skywarp, as well as a short little info on why the animated line is going so slowly here in America. Hope that informed you guys well. So yeah, let's end this review now. I'm sure it's getting too tiring. That's all I have to say, and this is Optimus Smythe signing off.